वेलकम बैक टू आवर चैनल फ्रेंड्स, दिस साइड सोनिया हियर फ्रॉम ग्रोइंग क्राफ्ट। थैंक यू सो मच फॉर ड्रॉपिंग इन। नाउ बिफोर वी स्टार्ट दिस वीडियो, प्लीज डू मेक श्योर दैट यू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल एंड डू नॉट फॉरगेट टू हिट द बेल आइकन सो दैट यू डू नॉट मिस आउट एनी ऑफ आवर अपडेट्स। ऑल्सो डू चेक आवर वेबसाइट www.growingcraft.com एंड लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। दिस वन आई वॉज रिक्वेस्टेड बाई सो मेनी ऑफ यू टू मेक लेस molds, beautiful laces, and I am super happy that finally I'm showing this video. So yes, actually I have tried this in a lot of variations, but this is one of the variations which I really liked and I want to share it with you all, and I hope you all will like it. So of course I have listed down all the supplies linked down in the description box. I'm really sorry that my lace is so shabby because I have been working on this like day and night. And I have done tons of laces with this beautiful design. So the lace mold which I have has four designs and they are absolutely gorgeous and beautiful. So I just thought of trying my hands on this one. So what I'm going to use is my Montmartre modeling paste. This is one of the best modeling paste what you can have in your craft room. And then of course I will need my palette knife, and we are going to mix one secret ingredient that I'm going to show you in some time. Now you must be wondering why I have two table mats here. I will tell you, because once you do your lace work, then you need to keep it on a flat surface for a good amount of time. So of course this is my main working table, so this is my main craft mat. So I have just kept this one so that once I do with my laying work, I can just keep it aside as it is to dry out, because it's going to take time to dry out. So yeah, that's the only reason. So let's get started. Now here I'm going to have my acrylic block. Now acrylic block, I have been using these for a good 2-3 years. They are still as it is and I love using it. We need to add our secret ingredient, but before that I'm going to take out my modeling paste. Now I am going to need a good amount of modeling paste here. Okay, so this is my modeling paste. Why I have picked up an acrylic block, because it becomes much more easier to just take out all the modeling paste from the base. And now here I'm going to have my liquid adhesive, so it should be almost the equal quantity. And now you have to mix this well. Now this is a very important step. Okay, you have to make sure that you mix this really well. Now making these laces looks very easy, but then it can be a little tricky if you don't do it in a correct way. So what you need to do is you just need to make sure that you follow all the steps really well. Okay, so I know many of you might be thinking, why have we have to use adhesives, why not directly with the modeling paste? You can do it, but there are very high chances of it getting damaged. So that's the reason I always prefer to have my adhesive on this. And you need to make sure that the consistency is just perfect so that you can do it. Now anyways, I am going to leave it on my main mat. So what you can do is, if you are doing it on a bigger surface, you can just do it on the lace and keep the tray or the surface as it is so that it does not get damaged at all. Okay, now with my palette knife, I'll start pouring in my adhesive and my modeling paste, and you have to be careful that you apply this really well. Okay, now once I'm doing this, let me just cover this a little bit so that I can tell you what all the nicks and knacks and what are all the different things which you need to follow in this step. So first we are going to fully cover this up with our modeling paste. Now here you will have to be really generous when you are doing this. When I say generous, you really don't have to pour in like everything here, but you have to make sure that you cover this up completely. So honestly, in one areas you will just have to do it 2-3 times. Like you will have to move on your palette knife 2-3 times to make sure that it sticks well and there should not be any gaps. If there will be any gaps, then it will not come out beautifully. So you have to Make sure that there should not be any bubbles or gaps or wrinkles out there. Okay. So for this you can use any of your bases. If you don't have a palette knife, you can use your old debit card or credit cards. But I have been using palette knives for quite long time now, and that's why I always vouch for them, that these are one of the best tools. Like, there are a few tools which I really 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 like, and I always suggest you to go for some of the very limited tools, but to have a good one so that your crafting becomes easier. Okay, now as you can see, I have just covered half of my portion and so much of my modeling paste, and the adhesive mixture is gone. Why? Because we feel that there is hardly any space here, but it takes a lot of things inside, and that's when you get a very nice and intricate designs. Now let me do some more mixture work. Let me have some more mixture here. First I'll add my adhesive. And now I'm going to have my modeling paste. Okay, now once I'm done with this, again I'm going to mix it well. So like I always say, you have to make sure that it mix up well. The consistency should be good. Otherwise, if it is not going to mix up well, then when you are going to peel it off, it will just break, and we definitely, definitely don't want that. Okay, that's the reason we have to mix this well. Once I'm happy with my mixture, I'm going to apply this on my lace. Now in the description box, I have given the links of this lace. I got it from Amazon, honestly, and I loved it. I was not very sure how I'm going to use it, but the day I tried this lace making, I loved it. So these are so versatile. You can actually use these laces for your mixed media projects, for your craft projects, for your DIY home decor projects, and you can just put up these laces on your table mats or on your wall hangings or anything, and they are going to look so gorgeous. So trust me, you have to try this out. A little bit of more paste here and there. Okay, now I'm just going to remove all the excessive clay from here. And wherever I feel that there are some gaps, I'm going to fill it off. So this takes a little time, but you have to be a little patient. And honestly, if you enjoy crafting, you are not going to get bored of this step at all. So you just need to keep on adding your paste just to make sure that there are no gaps or bubbles, otherwise your designs are not going to come out. Okay, so here I am almost done. Okay, now here is a very 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 important step. Let me just do this. Okay, now here is a very important step. Take your palette knife, just take it in a straight direction. This is to make sure that whatever the excessive design is there, it comes out. Let me just show you and tell you how I'm trying to clean it up. So see, in this design you have these patches. Okay, let me show you with this one. Okay, now this is the lace what I have made. Now these are the small holes and the design. So these are the main detailings which should be visible. If these are not visible, it's not going to work out. It's not going to look beautiful. It's just going to look like a plain patch of mold. So that's why you need to clear up as much as you can. You can't over rub this, because if you over rub this, it is just going to lose its shape, and we don't want that. Okay, you just need to gently remove all the excessive, whatever you can. If you want, you can just start with one of the molds and do it, but here I have a very big palette knife. So this is the largest size. So with this, I can actually take up everything here. Now this is done. This is almost done. Now once this process is done, then you need to let it dry. Now how to know that you have removed all the excessive portions? So whatever the detailing designs you see in the center, that should be clearly visible. Okay, now let me just cover up one of the patches. Now can you see here the design is not visible? So it should be somewhere like this that your designs are visible. That's an indication that you have removed all the excessive designs from the top portion. Okay, now this is done. Now very nicely I'm just going to let it dry for good amount of time, and once this dries out then we will be back. Okay, so it's day two and this has dried out, and of course it had to dry because this is really thin and it's been more than 18 hours that I had dried, let it dry completely. So these are the two previous laces what I had done, and I am hoping that this will come out really well. So I'm going to be really careful before peeling it off. So you need to be really gentle. You cannot do this in very hush hush hush, and you need to start peeling this off. Okay, now this will start coming out very easily, but like I said, you will have to be a little careful because all the designs what we have here are extremely delicate. So can you see this? This is coming out so gorgeously. I'm just hoping that it does not break. So I'll just do a little pressing work from the back side so that it leaves the mold and it comes out easily. So this will actually help me in taking this out. Okay, like I said, I'm going to be really gentle with this one. I'm just going to be very quickly peeling this off from both the sides. Now this step takes a little time, but then it's absolutely pleasure to just take it out because you have done so much of effort in making these beautiful laces. And of course, like I said, we want them to come out as neatly as possible. So even if it breaks, you can stick it. It's absolutely fine. And you can see how beautifully my lace is coming out. I'm trying to be really gentle and really easy with these molds. Okay. Yeah. Ah, this looks gorgeous and this looks really beautiful. So like I said, you just need to be a little gentle. So these are ready and these are looking absolutely, absolutely gorgeous. I know you can't see me, but I think from my voice you can make out that I'm extremely happy with the way they are looking. They look absolutely gorgeous and beautiful. Yeah, on some of the areas I can see excessive of the modeling paste. That is because I had not cleaned that part properly. So I should have done that. Otherwise, it's looking beautiful, 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 and I'm happy. And I hope that you all are going to try this really soon. Of course, I'm sharing on all the links down in the description box. Do check that. Thank you so much once again. Take care. Bye bye.